Actually, on the último, going to the paliza, of the atrás de la paliza, lobbying him, telling him, you watch my back, you must go through with you. There are people in healthcare, poets, engineers, all of them focusing on how do they help my lips up. There are people on the streets, literally present day, like what we call protesting. They were protesting. So we think, like, oh, we've reached, like, a point that there's no turning back. No. This is the end, what we are witnessing this month. This is the beginning of the end of the Israeli separatism. The beginning of the end. And I want you guys all to internalize that. We are at 75 years. So let's this is the law. So, revoked a license that I hadn't even had the opportunity to sit for the exam yet at this point. And so what you're seeing, and I want to paint this image not to instill fear or to make folks nervous that this might happen to you. No, not at all, because we are going to implement the new technologies. Maybe some lessons to be upon them. And we are the moments that we have. We are the people of truth, and we are the people of justice. And like we all know, justice will prevail. And so they don't, these are not tactics that scare me, but this is just to sort of paint an image about the lens the Zionist army goes and continues to go to censor and stifle people who speak of their philosophy. And actually, the school itself, Tinley School of Law, has now permanently banned student speakers at commencement. So this graduating class after me will not have a student speaker at their commencement ceremony, which is, again, an institution scrambling to appease the Zionists at the expense of their own students and at the expense of this liberation movement. All that said, right, this is what happened, but I stand before you today, and I am telling you that in New York City, we have protested almost every single day, and at the front of that protest, I am holding the mic. And I say that because we will not be scared, we will not be censored, we will not be bullied, and we will not be stifled, because we cannot afford it. No, I think it's important to increase morale and talk about how, yes, we are mourning, yes, we are scared, yes, we are nervous, but we also must put our anxieties into perspective. What we have witnessed in Gaza, what we've witnessed is occupation due to the Palestinian people for the last 75 plus years. It's beyond words. We have witnessed Palestinian fathers scramble for their kids beneath the rubble. We have witnessed Palestinian mothers shout for 5, 6, 7 of their kids and be met with deafening silence. We have witnessed little children alone shaking in hospitals. We have witnessed siblings alone with no family left behind. We have witnessed family lines, entire family lines, completely erased at the hands of the Zionist entity. And the unfortunate truth is that it is our tax money that pays for it. It is our tax dollars that continues to fund this. And every single time we bite our tongue, every single time we choose to remain silent, we embolden, we aid and abet more than we already are with our tax dollars. We are aiding and abetting with silence, and we can no longer afford to do that. Not today, not yesterday, not tomorrow. practice